Hey everyone, this is Ken back with another tutorial on a potato, wheat, and carrot farm. Now what makes it so different is the fact that I specifically designed this for survival mode. And there's no repeaters in the entire design. Fantastic. Now it uses very little material and it works very effectively. Okay, this also works on the PlayStation, Xbox, and PC. Now once activated, the water comes through, it pushes all the crops, the potatoes, the carrots, the wheat that you planted forward. Once you turn it off, you just collect everything you just planted and you're good to go. As you can see, it works perfectly fine. What's amazing about it, we don't even use sticky pistons at any point. Now let me show you the materials we're going to be using for this build, okay? They're all basic materials. You're going to need a dirt block of your choice. If you plan on building this at any location, you will need dirt. A block of your choice, a half slab. You will need sand or gravel, either one, for the mechanism itself to actually work properly, okay? Because we're not going to be using any kind of sticky pistons. You're going to need a plain piston, redstone dust, and a redstone torch, and a lever. So I want you to dig a hole 9 blocks wide and 9 blocks long in the middle. Now keep in mind the side, just dig about 2 blocks wide. Alright, once you've done that, it should be about 3 blocks deep, okay, as you can see. Now facing the back wall, I want you to place your block of your choice, 4 on each side. Okay, just like so. And that will be the back part of the farm. Now place 1 right in the front, in the middle, and then 1 right in the back, but 1 block away from the wall in the middle. Okay, once we have that layout all set up, all right, we're going to start placing our redstone torches in this proper location. Okay, place it right in the front of those blocks, and then 1 right behind that block, and then a block right on top of that torch in the middle. Okay, it should look just like this. Once you've done that, add a redstone dust right across the blocks. As you can see, it'll turn off the mechanism because that block on top is powering those redstone dust, and just add 1 parallel straight from 1 block from the back to the end, all the way till you hit the top of that block. Okay, it's 1 straight line. Once you've done that, alright, I want you to add a block of your choice. I'm gonna use a smooth stone in this case, right on top, because that's where our lever mechanism is gonna be at. Okay, place the lever right on top, because once that's activated, it'll activate that redstone. You see? Perfect. I'll show you a little more how that works. Then I want you to add a regular piston right on top of the first torches we laid on each side, okay? Just like so. Perfect. You should have this kind of format at this point. Once you've done that, let's get the smooth stone. Think about 4 blocks on each side from the lever, okay? That's where all the crops are going to actually land on. Now, we're going to use gravel and place it right on top the pistons, because gravel tends to just fall straight on. But you'll see, it works perfectly smooth. Now we're gonna need a half slab at one point, okay, and I'll explain why. Now right there, just add a smooth stone covering that right up 2 blocks high, and then go all the way up to this point, right? Because you don't want to add a block there, you want to add a half slab, because you don't want to lose the connection between the lever and that redstone. See, if you put a block there, it's going to cut off the connection. You'll see what happens. That's all that gravel is going to go down. You see? It went right back up. When you add a half slab, it doesn't interfere with that connection. Okay? Perfect. Once you've done that, just go right behind. And I want you to place the smooth stone right on top of that rest stone, which is parallel to the ground. And then stretch that right around, because we're going to put water in that at one point. Now cover the middle up perfectly. Then we're going to use a spruce wood and cover the edges, the whole side. We're going to wrap that right around, just like so. From one end all the way around to the other. Now you can use anything else you want, but in this tutorial I'm going to use spruce wood just for demonstration. Once you're done, you should have this kind of layout. Now I want you to add water in the middle and in the back pockets. Okay, one in the middle and one on the buckets of water on the left and the right. Once you've done that, just cover the water in the middle. Okay, you can either use a solid block of your choice. I'm going to use spruce wood. Just cover that right up. Just like so. Or, if you want, you can also use a half slab, which works just as, works the same way. Okay, just place it right across on the top. Make sure not to interfere with the water. Let me put two blocks there. Great. Now I want you to get your wooden fence at this point, and we're going to place it right on top of the spruce wood from one end all the way around to the other. Perfect. Hold on, I missed one spot. Now once you've done that, you're good to go. Now this is a perfect way to have an automatic farm in survival, because I know materials are hard to get and to make a repeater is a bit of a pain. But with this design, it's very basic and very effective. Please leave a comment and subscribe. Thank you.